Good afternoon, everybody. This is Sangeeta Saxena, Editor, Aviation and Defense Universe, getting you live from Hyderabad. We are here at the HICC, which is a Hyderabad International Convention Center, and we are at the AeroMart Hyderabad, an Indo-French collaboration on aerospace and defense. And we have with us the man himself, who's been behind all this effort we've been seeing for the last 4 days, and we're going to see it for another 2 days, Mr. Praveen PA, the Director, Aerospace and Defense at Government of Telangana. Welcome, Praveen, to ADU's chat room.
Thank you, Sangeeta ji.
And Praveen, what was the purpose of getting the French here?
There's a lot of aerospace and defense activity in Hyderabad, but unfortunately, we were not having a Def Expo here, so we thought we'll create an event which will be more B2B centric and creating a lot of opportunities for our local MSMEs. We didn't want to create a conference for conference sake. We really wanted to have solid B2B meetings happening. So we found the right partner with DCI Aerospace France, who does supply chain needs for Boeing, various OEMs like Leonardo, Boeing, Mitsubishi, etc. And the preparation was over 6 months. We tried to kind of curate a lot of themes and speakers, and also reached out to most of the OEMs, foreign OEMs. The larger players in India like Tata's, etc. And interestingly, we also got a lot of support from the DPSU. So we have a very strong presence of DPSUs here. We have HAL, who's taken a lead, BDL, Midhani, etc. And this has now resulted into an event which was very attractive for the MSMEs to discuss with their suppliers directly. And this event has right now attracted more than 200 companies, more than 30 OEMs are present here today, and we have 700 odd registered senior delegates and some 3,500 B2B meetings already registered in our system, and that is happening all around, as you can see there. The advantage of having a B2B focus was that only the key decision makers will come in for this event, because someone who's empowered to represent their company and take a decision. So everyone is quite happy with the kind of the quality of the conference which we had, the quality of the B2B meets, and I'm sure that a lot of these meetings will translate into a very strong order flow for the MSMEs, a very strong possibility for partnership between OEMs and supply chain. And also for the region, that is Telangana, we really look forward to kind of hosting a lot of these additional investments, which will create more economic activity, more employment, and more investment in the region. And our Honorable Minister, Mr. Sridhar Babu, had inaugurated it yesterday. We also had the earlier DRDO Secretary and currently the Aeronautical Society of India President, Dr. Satish Reddy, along with our Special Chief Secretary Jay Shanjanji, who was there with us for the inaugural, along with a very strong leadership team from Airbus, from Tata, from Safran, from NRSC representing the space. So we had a collection of all of these themes, which is unique, pretty unique, because most of the other shows are very specific to aviation, defense, space, etc. But here we could see a congregation of UAV, space, defense and aerospace, and almost all of them are very keen to speak to our MSMEs, and there's a lot of productive meetings happening right now. We hope that the two-day deliberations will really be remembered as one of the best aerospace and defense event hosted at a regional level in India.
That's wonderful. Absolutely. You've actually done my work and you've already covered everything. But let me ask you one thing. When your minister was speaking yesterday and he spoke about the Skills University, and he said that the aerospace and defense sector will also be a part of the courses which will happen there. What did he mean? Has it already begun, or are you planning something like that?
The government is planning for building a skills university. In fact, what the minister also alluded to was it will be an industry-run, industry-driven initiative, because we don't want another engineering college. We really want to create institutions where the industry will predict as to what kind of skills gap that they will that they foresee in the next 5 to 10 years, and then prepare courses, contribute in terms of course creation, curriculum creation, etc., and also ensure that the placements are also being assured at one level. So that is one initiative. The minister also mentioned that there is a very strong program right now to upgrade all the ITIs in the state to meet the new Industry 4.0 requirements, and there will be a lot of training which will be given on AI, ML and the emerging tech side also, so that they are well prepared for the advanced manufacturing projects which are coming to Hyderabad. And in fact, we also have created an AI city to, and the state has an aim to kind of create, to make Telangana the AI hub of India. So it's all coming together, and we really want to kind of make the state the leader in all these emerging techs, and aerospace and defense is a critical department for us, a critical sector for us. So anything aligned with that will certainly be taken care of in the skilling as well as the other initiatives around.
And you know, you also had the MRO industry represented, but with Safran being such a big one in the sector for engines, and GMR already very strongly entrenched in the market, so does it scare away the other MROs?
In fact, Safran was the late entrant to Hyderabad. We had GMR Aerospace, GMR Aerotechnic as a strong MRO. Mm. We also have Air India Engineering Services, which had its MRO for a long time. Safran was the latest entrant. In fact, it's the first engine MRO by any foreign OEM in India. They had evaluated 4-5 stages, and the whole process of evaluation went around 3-4 years. And finally, they kind of narrowed down to Telangana. And because they had two initial investments made in 2018, they made a small investment of 64 crores. They were quite happy with that. 2020, they expanded to a 450 crore aero engine parts manufacturing facility. So for them, 2022, the announcement of aero engine MRO was quite easy, because the earlier two projects had shown them that this is a place that they could really set off, and they have a target of 2025 to launch the project, and it's going to be the largest engine MRO for Safran globally. That they got 8 other MROs across the world. This is going to be the largest, and that's a prestigious investment which India has attracted.
Right, and you know, the last 2 days, the conference sessions have been very nice. The show has really taken off well. I think in many, many years, I haven't seen such a good, well-attended inaugural session. So hats off to you, Praveen, for managing the show. It's wonderful. And I think at the end of the day, it'll be great. Telangana is already leading. You don't have to say it will lead. It's already leading. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.